So, today we're taking a quick look at a special type of NFC chip. This particular one can work on metal surfaces. Now, I'm not sure whether you'll be completely aware, but because of the way near-field communication technology works, metal near your tag or under your tag can cause interference. Effectively, the field that your device may generate becomes scattered by other metal objects around the tag you're trying to read. So what we have to do if we're going to use a tag on a metal surface is we have to back it first. And so this particular tag, which hopefully you can see if I can, it's probably going to be very difficult for you to get an idea of exactly how this tag is working, but essentially there is a rubber back on this. So you have a piece of rubber sitting between the tag and the surface it's going to be going onto. And this creates an isolation, basically. It earths it. So the tag then, in theory, is just sitting on a layer above the metal surface. That will then allow your NFC reader to properly energize the tag and read the information from it. These are absolutely fantastic for outdoor use. They're absolutely brilliant for versatility more than anything else, because on this situation, in this scenario, this one type of tag can be used anywhere. So you don't have to worry about if you're putting it onto metal or wood or any other surface. If you use this particular type of tag with the isolation layer there, you can use it anywhere. You don't have to second guess or worry about taking multiple types of tags out to do a particular job. One tag does it all, basically. These are nice and waterproof as well, so they do work outside. How durable they'll be over time, though, with heat and so on getting into them, not too sure. Not tested that myself just yet. But certainly the ability to pop these tags outside for a reasonable duration during an event or so on, and know that they're going to be reasonably safe from the elements, is absolutely fantastic. These particular tags, 137 bytes of information. That should be more than enough to store URLs, phone numbers, basic contact information. Although if you were trying to store more longer form URLs, for instance, you're probably going to want to use a bit.ly shortener on them. Lovely, lovely little tags.